Sinai. My name is Richard Salcedo, and I'm one of the educational consultants for Music for All. And I would like to bring to the podium right now someone very special, a great friend of ours here at Music for All. He is the Director of Education and Artist Relations for our presenting sponsor and our great friends at the Yamaha Corporation, and he'll introduce the band. Would you help me welcome to the microphone Mr. John Whitman?
Aspects by far with our work with Yamaha Corporation and Music for All is the joy that happens with bringing world-class artists together with amazing high school musicians, adding the element of music, putting them in a room together for a few days, shaking it up and seeing what happens. Folks, the stars have aligned for us this evening. We have got such an amazing program with such amazing talent for you. I know you're going to love it. Our guest director, our conductor this evening, is Mr. Mike Tamaro. And Mike teaches at Duquesne University. He's a very, very well-renowned jazz educator, composer, arranger, and a very, very gifted saxophone artist in his own right. Our soloist tonight is, if you lived out in LA and you were in the studio scene, if you were in the major production of music recordings or the large show, Oscars, etc., Emmys, all you'd have to do is say, we need Andy on trombone, and everybody knows you'd be talking about Mr. Andy Martin. So tonight, I'd like to ask you all to just loosen those ties, get ready for a wonderful, wonderful night of jazz. Please help me welcome Mike Tamaro, Andy Martin, and the 2017 Jazz Band of America.
Thank you. Thank you. Tim has chosen to play a really great piece of music, one of the most influential bands, continues to be an influential band, is the Vanguard Jazz Orchestra, which started out as the Thad Jones Mel Lewis Band way back in the 60s, and the latest incarnation of the band has iconic writers such as Jim McNeely and certainly one of the masters, Bob Brookmeyer. This is a piece that Bob Brookmeyer composed for the band, specifically for one of the tenor players of the band, a guy named Rich Perry. This is from a suite called Suite for Three. We're going to feature Tim now on Suite for Three, Rich.
Thank you.
Being a very tried and true Pittsburgher, I always try to make a point of playing something on any concert I do by a Pittsburgher. And the person I'm going to name here is probably someone you have never heard of, and you should. Her name is Mary Lou Williams, very, very influential woman in the jazz world, born in Pittsburgh, and raised in Pittsburgh. I won't take time right now to talk about her biography, but it's an incredible one. But she's one of our great composers from Pittsburgh, another one being Billy Strayhorn and Henry Mancini, a couple greats there. So this is a piece by Mary Lou Williams, very interesting piece of music. Later on in her life, she decided to devote a lot of her life to religion, and so she wrote one of the first jazz masses we have in existence. And this is a piece that is a quasi-religious piece of music that she wrote. It's called Ode to Saint Cecilia. Those of you who don't happen to know, Saint Cecilia is the patron saint of music. So we're going to play Mary Lou Williams' Ode to Saint Cecilia for you right now.
Thank you.
is a Yamaha performing artist, such a wonderful teacher, educator, performer, wonderful person. Please welcome to the stage, Annie Martin. Thank you.
is entitled Black Orpheus. It also goes back up with other titles, Day in the Life of a Fool, and the actual title of the tune is Manhã de Carnaval, which is a Brazilian, the morning of the carnival, which they have in February as a big celebration of life in Brazil. That particular tune is written by Luis Bonfá, and the arrangement by the great Tom Cubas, a good friend of mine. And we're going to continue on with another Tom Cubas arrangement. And this is a beautiful composition, a ballad written by his wife, Carol Jolin. And it's entitled, Imagine What a Change Will Do.
Oh.
so this is what's going to happen. So every concert that I ever play, you guys are supposed to show up and be the audience, okay? That's all there is to it. You're the best audience that we've ever played for, at least I've ever played for. This is awesome. But, hey, one more time. Let's hear it for this great band right here. How about that? We got to rehearse yesterday for the first time with me. And I have to tell you, I was blown away. It's Mike didn't warn me how good these kids are. These kids are awesome. High school level kids playing like this, this is a ridiculous feat for these guys. And I just can't believe it. So, my final tune of this concert, I know this, we're gonna continue on after me, you're gonna get rid of me after this next one, and this is a jazz standard entitled, There Will Never Be Another You.
Thank you.
Summer Camargo on trumpet. John Fernandez on bass trombone. So this is, before we begin our rather long finale, I have a few thank yous I'd certainly like to make. This has been such an amazing experience for me. As a writer, this is about as good as it gets, which is amazing, absolutely amazing. Again, as Andy said, we never expected this level of musicality from the students. First of all, I'd like to thank Music for All, and especially Richard Saucedo for asking me to do this. Again, I had no idea how phenomenal this would be. This is literally life-changing. The band would also like to thank the folks who took care of us for the past few days. Brian Blocker, who was our assistant. Thank you, Brian. Thank you to our two chaperones, to Howard Carpenter and Heather Camargo. Very appreciative of them. I'd also, you can clap for them. They worked hard. As in all the assistants and chaperones these past 3 days. I'd also like to put a special thanks out to Yamaha. Yamaha has been incredibly good for me. I've been with Yamaha for over 25 years, and I'm just so very proud to say that I'm working with that corporation. It's an amazing group of folks. Special thanks to John Whitman, Jalissa Gasco, Jennifer Veerling, all the folks at Yamaha. So many thanks. Band, thank you. I just can't believe what the kind of music you guys have created in a very short amount of time. 20 hours of rehearsal, and this is just amazing. Please, a hand for the band. So this rather long finale we're going to do for you right now is a piece of music that's only ever been played in its entirety once before. It was by a professional band, the Pittsburgh Jazz Orchestra, a group I co-lead with Sean Jones. It was written in 2014. I was commissioned by the Pittsburgh Trust Arts Council to write this, and it's a Four Seasons suite. And so what we'd like to do is, this is certainly concert material, but nonetheless, this is a jazz concert. So what I'd like to do is just sort of name the movements for you, and then I'm going to introduce the soloist as we go. So please feel free to clap for them, not waiting until the very end of the whole thing. So Four Seasons, and I chose for each of these one descriptive word that goes with each of the seasons. So the first movement is Autumn Glow. Second movement is Winter Calm. Third movement is Spring Joy. And the fourth movement is Summer Heat. Here's the Four Seasons Suite.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
forward. Ian Mitch Butler on guitar. David Dosh on trombone. So this last movement, Summer Heat, features the remaining movement. By the time we finish this, we'll have heard everybody in the band, which is an amazing thing. It's going to feature Gabe Carpenter on drums, Joe Sandholz on trumpet, and Griffin Ross on tenor saxophone. Here is Summer Heat.
Thank you.
Let's hear it for this man right here. Mike. Oh, yes. Awesome.